It's time once again to slip into your camo, grab your bow, and join us out in the field for another episode of the Up North Journal, presented by PSE Archery. The Up North Journal crew is knocked and ready to rock for another exciting adventure. So let's step outside and hit the trail.
This episode of the Up North Journal podcast is brought to you by PSE Archery,
Carbon Express,
Fourth Arrow Camera Arms,
Wind Scent Hunting Sense,
Killer Food Plots, Seeds, Supplements, and Attractants,
Cabela's,
Spot Shooters,
Limwalker Game Calls,
Twisted Minds Bowstrings,
Hunter's Blend Coffee,
Antler Action,
and Family Traditions Tree Stand.
And don't forget, you can catch us in syndication at 2 p.m. Eastern Time on goodtalkradio.com.
Welcome back to another episode of the Up North Journal, everybody. I'm host Mike Adams, and we are not in the cabin tonight. I'm actually in the deer woods, walking back to my stand. You know, we didn't bring you an episode this week, so I thought I'd catch up on what's been going on the last couple days up here at camp. So, enjoy the walk with me as I make my way to the stand. As you can probably hear in the background, we got a little bit of wind today. I'll try to record as long as it doesn't get too bad. Walking back through my hunting area right now. Probably 300-400 yards away from my stand. We had Dan DeFaul up here Saturday. Him and I came up, but it rained, actually poured all day long. Man, I'm walking on top of a huge footprint right now. Big, big deer. That's encouraging to see. I apologize for the wind. I'll see if I can't turn the mic here a little bit. But we got started. Danny didn't have such good luck. He had a flat tire on the way up. So he had to stop and take care of business. So I just went ahead and stopped and got groceries and waited for him to catch up. Made a quick pit stop at Cabela's. Can't come north while stopping at Cabela's, right? I'm walking along the edge of food plot here. See if I can see anything down through the trees here. Wish you guys could see this, man. It's beautiful. Bluebird skies tonight. We got just a little bit of wind, though. Not liking it. I could do without the wind. But, like I said, we finally got up here and it poured down rain all day Saturday. So, we sat around camp, got everything ready. And then Saturday night, Dan Yasa came in to camp, PSC manager, and we got after it Sunday morning. I thought I saw something. So we got up about 5 o'clock. I realized it was a little too early. Got up and cooked breakfast. Got our gear together, checked the weather, found out the wind direction, and proceeded to put both of them in stands. And then I headed to a stand that I'm heading to tonight, actually. And it was cold, probably between 35 and 40, rainy, drizzly, but we weren't going to let that stop us. Man, this is a heavy pack today. Got too much gear in my pack. Actually, I won't stop here for just a second. But we got into our stands and we sat till 10:30, I believe. And the only person that seen anything was Dan Yasa. He saw a 6-point. I didn't see anything in my stand. Danny didn't see anything where he was at. We had him set up on a scrape. So, I was hoping that he'd see some action. He had a doe tag that he was itching to punch. But no bucks or does come through. and dance. Yes, I only saw the one buck. And I didn't see squat. But that's hunting, you know. Man, I'm walking underneath a Widowmaker limb right now on that oak tree. This limb always scares the crap out of me. Especially when the wind's blowing. It's not blowing too bad now, though. Getting underneath this thing. Hanging right over the two track. Man, what a beautiful evening. Hey, I saw my first animal. It goes blue jay. So, that was pretty much a bust on the Sunday morning hunt. And then Mr. DeFaw had to get back home, unfortunately. So he only got to hunt one morning. But we expect him to come back up during muzzleloader season. Help us with our doe management. Alright, getting into my hunting area now. I need to slow it down a little bit. Take it easy. Be a little bit quieter here. It's not like I could do anything anyway. I don't have an arrow knocked. It's on my backpack. So, fixed launch. Dan had a business call he had to go take. Check with a PSC dealer up here in the area. And then when he got back, he found me asleep on the couch, as usual, in the afternoon. And about 2:30, we got things around and got after it. When I came out, I put him in a new stand. And I sat where he sat for the morning hunt. So, I tell you what, I'm getting real close here. I'm going to get up in my stand and we'll tell the rest of the story. So, I'd say I'd step outside and we'll be right back, but I'm already outside, so we'll be right back after this.
PSC Archery has reinvented the way you buy bows.
From now on, you can make the most educated decision possible
by basing your bow choice specifically on your shooting needs and goals.
All you need to do is ask yourself, what kind of shooter am I? What do I want to achieve?
PSC will help find the right category for you.
So, what kind of shooter are you?
Find out at PSCArchery.com.
Welcome back, second segment of the show. Yes, I made it into the tree stand. Sitting, 16 feet, 18 feet above the ground in my family traditions tree stand. Sitting up here with the camera, got it all set. The wind is finally starting to die down a little bit, which is good. And still a bluebird sky, beautiful out. I just wish the sun wasn't shining in my face. Makes it a little difficult to see. You gotta keep moving around just as the sun moves. You gotta put a tree between you and the sun to be able to see. But that's what we got to do because we've got a west wind. What little bit of wind is that left now? But we went to break. Told you we made our way in for the evening hunt right after lunch and everything. So got Dan set up in a stand that we've not hunted before and usually has pretty good activity, so thought that'd be a good place to put him. Hopefully he can see something, maybe shoot a doe, maybe sees even possibly a bear. You never can tell. But got him in stand and I took off, and I actually went and sat in the stand that he was in that morning. So the same one that he saw the 6-point in, so that's
close by, probably about 300 yards away from them, and wind was right, and I thought, what the heck, you know, we'll set in that stand. So got up in there, and make a long story short, his evening hunt was a bust. He didn't see anything, so that was kind of discouraging. And you begin to question, you know, what's going on here. You know, we only saw one deer the previous day, that morning, on the morning hunt, and we had three people out. It's like, what the heck, what's going on? So I was sitting in my stand, and was kind of thinking the same thing, because it was a bust right up until the very end. But I did happen to see a partridge walk right in front of me. I thought, dude, you might want to leave, or you might go home in the pot and become dinner for the night. But I was hunting deer, so that was my game. And I did see a bald eagle. Bald eagle swooped over probably 30, 40 feet above my tree. That was awesome. I mean, it's so cool to see a bald eagle, especially up close and personal like that. Any chance you get to see them is a real treat. And it's the second one I've seen this weekend. So, seen one when we were driving up. Danny and I were coming up, but didn't see anything until about 6:15. And I happened to see two does on the field. They were about 150, 200 yards in front of me, so just kind of kept an eye on them. They lasted for about 15 minutes, and they made their way off the field. Of course, not in my direction, but at least I saw some deer. And then about 6:40, I mean, it was almost dark. It's starting to get lights dropping fast, and I noticed another doe in the field. And she was kind of in the same general area, and I'm watching her. And then between me and her is a patch of woods to my left. And out of that patch of woods, I hear a grunt. And I'm like, okay, I know what that is. And got my bow and got in position, just hoping it might be a little game of cat and mouse and chase, and maybe they'd come my way. But the doe took off in the opposite direction. You know, all you see was the flag and see her running. So that was the end of seeing her, and then all of a sudden he hit the field. And could tell it was a buck, but couldn't really see anything with the antlers, any definition or anything, because the light was low. But you could tell that he had a big body. He was a big body buck. You know, so I'm thinking he's probably at least, you know, 3.5 year old. He wasn't like these other 2.5 year old bucks. He had some size to him. Even in the low light, you could tell from the shadow, the way he carried himself. And he went straight across in front of me, probably 100, 125 yards out. And he disappeared into the woods to my right, and that was pretty much the end of that. But it was really exciting. Got my blood pumping. I mean, that's why we're here. That's why we do what we do. Just to get out and experience stuff like that. But it was pretty awesome. So, but Dan, like I said, didn't see anything. And at least he was on the board for the morning with the one buck, and I was on the board seeing four deer in the evening. And of course Danny wasn't with us. He'd already taken off and went home. Unfortunately, he couldn't manage to stay, so he had to get home. But that was Sunday. And you know, the weather was kind of drizzly that evening, off and on, cloudy. Wind was blowing. Ooh, I see a black squirrel. See two of them. There's another one. That's pretty cool. There's quite a few of them right here in this area. But got a little damp again last night. You know, got cold. I got cold pretty quick, actually. And it was just a heavy, heavy damp weather yesterday. But we knew the forecast was supposed to change. You know, we talked about that in the evening, checked some stuff out and checked the Weather Channel and checked a couple other apps and things like that that I'll talk a little bit more about here in just a few minutes. But oh, there goes another one. Another black squirrel. That one's about 40 yards away. It's pretty cool. Look like skunks with no racing stripes, but smaller. But we got in, fixed another venison dinner. If y'all watched on Facebook, you saw Danny and I had venison veggies first night there before Dan got into camp. And I had more, so we fixed that for Dan Yasa and I last night. So, had some good food, and rested a little bit, kicked back, watched the end of the World Series. Go Sox. That was pretty cool. Bill watched that. And then got up this morning and hit it again. And got out here and got in stands by about 6:30. 7 o'clock. Yeah, it's probably about 7 o'clock, actually. Got up, made a little breakfast, and got things ready. Walked in, and this morning switched things up a little bit, though. But I tell you what, let's take another break here real quick, and when I come back, we'll talk a little bit about what we did this morning and what's happening around here right now. So, once again, I'd step outside, but I'm already there, so we'll be right back after this.
PSE Archery has always dominated the speed category. Now, the most revolutionary cam system ever to hit the market has perfected the shooting experience. Introducing PSE's Evolve Cam System, featuring extremely high let-off capabilities and the smoothest draw cycle in history. No other cam system has ever delivered this level of total comfort and total control. Experience PSE. Experience performance.
Welcome back, third segment of the show. Sitting here in a glorious Michigan evening, watching the woods slowly lull itself to sleep. Sun's not set yet. It's not quite that late. But when I left you before the break, we had... Oh, there goes another black squirrel. Man, they're all over the place. We talked a little bit about getting ready to come out for this morning's hunt. So, like I said, we switched it up a little bit. I put Dan in the stand that I hunted yesterday morning, first morning. And so he could sit in some timber. He likes hunting the timber. And overlooking my food plot. About 100 yards off my food plot. And then... I went and sat at a new stand I'd set up overlooking a ravine, and it was pretty close to. Here comes wind again. It was overlooking a ravine, and on the other side of the ravine, I've got a little hunting shack. It's in what I call the pine thicket. It's in a little thicket area, and it's got a little opening that we're going to put a food plot in one day, hopefully. But I was sitting in my stand, new stand that I put up, and overlooking this ravine. It's had good sign in it. It's a good travel corridor. We've seen a lot of sign in there. Seen some deer moving through there pretty good too. So that's where I wanted to sit this morning. And the wind was coming out of the west northwest, and so I said, well, Dan will be in a good spot, sitting in the stand I was in the first day, and actually the one I'm in right now. And then I knew that stand that I was going to sit in that morning, you know, had some good potential. And we knew that the weather was supposed to break 8, 9 o'clock or so. So that's what we were planning on. Hopefully the deer be moving through the acorns and eating acorns and trying to get their candy off the forest floor before it's all gone. And, you know, we knew we had an opportunity to hunt that area, so let's do it. Wind was right. So we got out, got him set up. I got set up. And it must have been about 8 o'clock. I only seen one deer for the whole day, but about 8 o'clock over by my hunting shack, like I said, on the opposite side of the ravine in the pine thicket, I heard a deer blow and just keep blowing for about 5 minutes. And I'm like, man, what's going on, you know? Is that a deer with a coyote, you know? Or I didn't think the deer had winded me because the wind direction wasn't right. So just kept listening, trying to figure out what's going on. And after she quit blowing, I thought, well, you know, I better get ready. She might come through that ravine. And sure enough, here she come. And there's a little doe walked right by me broadside, 30 yards. And I'm thinking, man, I could pop you right now. But, you know, she was last year's fawn, maybe a 2.5-year-old. So it's like, that's not what we're here for. So I didn't shoot it and let it pass. So, but when she came through, man, she was really skittish. She had her tail tucked right between her legs. And she was on alert, high alert, just watching, looking, listening. I mean, really cautious. So I never did figure out what had spooked her until maybe a little later. And I'll get to that in just a second. But yeah, Dan had a real good hunt in the morning, or this morning. He saw either six. And I just got busted. I don't see a deer anywhere. I think it's behind me. Little buck. Actually, I don't know what he's blowing at. He's not blowing at me. Walked right up beside me here. Come out of a pine thicket. Right along the edge of the oaks here. He's about 50 yards off to the side. He might have winded me. It's possible. He ain't scared, though. He's just walking off. Slow. Looks like a little 4-point. Nice looking behind him back down towards the food plot. I wonder if there's a coyote in the area. No, he's standing there looking right down in the food plot. And now he's walking off. That was strange. I would have thought maybe he winded me or something, maybe, but I don't know, man. It didn't really act like it. I don't know if you guys could hear that, but that'll definitely get your attention. I know he didn't hear me because I'm barely whispering. He wasn't close enough to hear me. So, I can't remember where I was at now. What I was talking about Dan, where he was sitting here. He saw either 6 or 10 deer. He wasn't real sure. They kept meandering around and moving, but he saw at least 6 different deer. And it could have been 10. So let's make another scan here, making sure there's nothing around. But at one point he heard a buck grunting off in the distance, running around, but he never did see it. So maybe this little guy here that just came through. It's hard to say. So but after the morning hunt, we were coming in, and we were walking the two-track in, and in behind the area where that doe was blowing, we saw fresh coyote tracks from this morning, so it's very possible that's what she was blowing at. She might have picked that coyote up from where she was at. When she was blowing, she definitely could have seen him on the road. So, but that was a morning hunt. Dan packed up and headed out, and now I'm here to finish the job by myself. So we're sitting up here in northern Michigan, enjoying an evening, watching the sunset, waiting on deer. I'll tell you what, I'm going to take the last break, and when I come back, we'll talk a little bit about an app that I found, and that Dan Yasa told me about that I've been checking out, so we'll be right back after this.
Acceleration is part of PSE's DNA. PSE pioneered the speed movement. Now they've developed the vapor category to help you find the most powerful bows on the market to fit you.
High speed equates to intense power and building the momentum you need to be successful. Are you a vapor shooter? Find out at PSEArchery.com.
Welcome back. Last segment of the show. Yeah, I don't know which way where that little buck went. He kind of just walked off. Maybe he'll circle back around here in a minute. We'll get a better look at him and see what he's made of. But he's only a year and a half old buck. But when I went to break, I was telling you about this app that Dan told me about. It's called DeerCast. And actually, I don't know if it's made by the juries or the juries promote it or how that all works, but they're affiliated with it in some way, shape, or form. But it was pretty cool. It takes your area that you're in, as long as you've got a signal, and it pinpoints and it pulls all the weather information for your area. And it gives you leading indicators of deer movement around barometric pressure, temperature, wind, fronts moving through and all that. And it'll give you the indication of when the best time to be in the woods, according to all those factors are. And I was checking it out, and, you know, lo and behold, it was pretty accurate, because when we didn't see nothing, it said it was poor. It said, you know, poor conditions for seeing deer movement. It was supposed to pick up this morning, you know, around 8, 9 o'clock, and sure enough, that's when we started seeing deer. So, you know, it's this year it's free. Next year they're going to charge for it. So if you're looking for something with some weather application for deer hunting, you know, give it a look. It's called DeerCast. And, you know, check it out and see what you think about it and see if it applies for you, what you want to do in your hunt. So, well, that pretty much wraps up what we've done up here so far. So, hopefully this came across okay. Something a little different, something I've never done before. Just sit in a tree stand and barely whisper with a glove over top of the microphone. You know, in my headsets here, it sounds pretty good. So, hopefully I didn't bore you to death too much. But, you know, we've had a good time. It's been a little slow, but today it definitely picked up, and the weather's beautiful. So, and hopefully this week I'll be able to drop another episode to you as things progress, and we'll keep you updated as to what's going on. So y'all take care, get out in the woods, enjoy this weather. Hopefully where you're at it's nice as well, so take advantage of the time you've got and get in the woods and enjoy it, and hopefully you'll shoot some. So that'll do it for us for this episode.
And don't forget, you can catch us in syndication at 2 p.m. Eastern Time on goodtalkradio.com. This episode was brought to you by PSE Archery,
Carbon Express,
Fourth Arrow Camera Arms,
Wind Scent Hunting Scent,
Killer Food Plots Seeds, Supplements, and Attractants,
Cabela's,
Spot Shooters,
Limb Walker Game Calls,
Twisted Minds Bowstrings,
Hunter's Blend Coffee,
Antler Action,
and Family Traditions Tree Stands.
Thanks for listening, and join us again here next week. Until then, remember, as we always like to say, if you're out on the water or in the woods, shoot straight and be safe. Until next week on the Up North Journal.